If I had to describe Mad Max Fury Road with one song, it would have to be Metallica's Fuel. So without further ado,
give me fuel, give me fire, give me that which I desire!
Good evening, everyone. If you don't know, you should know. My name is Ramiz Khan, and I am a filmmaker and a film critic. A film critic who has been dormant, just like the film franchise I'm going to be talking about, Mad Max, because today we are reviewing Mad Max Fury Road. Mad Max is the fourth film in the dormant film franchise known as Mad Max. No Mel Gibson this time around. I presume he's doing stuff Mel Gibson usually does.
You wanted the number of my therapist? Don't you ever speak to him! Find your own goddamn therapist!
Stuff like that. Tom Hardy takes the helm of the character this time, and he embodies Mad Max perfectly. We all know Mad Max is a man of few words and a man of big action, and Tom Hardy is oh so perfect this time. And joining him is Charlize Theron as Imperator Furiosa. Together in this wasteland they call home, they bond to survive another day. They are being chased by multiple groups of marauders led by Immortan Joe. As Furiosa takes a bunch of breeders in this world are people who can actually give birth because this film takes place in the post-apocalyptic world. So she takes these breeders to give them a better life. So she kidnaps Immortan Joe's breeders. This is not a film. This is an experience. This film is directed by George Miller, who is a 70-year-old man, and it is shot by a 72-year-old man. This film has left every other action film I have seen in the past decade in the dust. This tops any stunts done in the Avengers. This tops any of the stunts done in the Fast and the Furious movies. This is an absolutely mind-blowing film. Michael Bay, take note. This is how you do an action movie. It is not just about CG, and it is not about just the stunt work of this film, but how it's centered around a two-hour chase. In that two-hour chase, we learn so much about our characters, and what we learn is very interesting. I love how Mad Max is fighting with the living and the dead, and his own past. I love stuff like that. Tom Hardy, first of all, he's an absolutely gorgeous human being. I believe we can call Tom Hardy the next action hero. He solidified himself, and this guy has insane range. Tom Hardy can be a bad guy and a good guy. I particularly enjoy his good guy roles more because a bad guy does not look that good. He should not be that pretty to be a bad guy. Tom Hardy is absolutely stunning. Even though he barely speaks, you can still feel his angst, you can still feel his pain, you can still feel his anger just through those beautiful eyes, just like he did with Bane. In Bane, he was handicapped, you could not see his mouth move, but those eyes were oh so powerful. Not only do I love the way this film looks, the cinematography is absolutely stunning, not only do I love the craftsmanship going into this movie, 80% stunt work, by the way, people, minimal use of CGI, and not only do I love the setting of this film, but I love the themes of this film. There are a bunch of religious themes interlaced in this movie. Our main character, Max, is literally on a cross for the first hour. Immortan Joe is our false prophet. Max and Furiosa team up to take down Immortan Joe. Furiosa arguably had more screen time and more lines than Mad Max, but that just solidifies that this movie was equally as important to Furiosa than it was to Mad Max. You could almost call this movie Furiosa with Mad Max Fury Road. This is an absolute stunner of a movie. Every Hollywood blockbuster filmmaker, take note, this is how you make a summer blockbuster. This is the best blockbuster I have seen in the past decade, action blockbuster, and this is the best summer movie you are going to see this year, without a doubt. So, without further ado, I have to give this film a final rating of 5 out of 5. It is an absolute masterpiece, and I must thank you very much for watching, and always remember to listen to Fuel by Metallica whilst watching this movie. Thank you very much. My name is Ramiz Khan. I am a filmmaker and a film critic, and I will see you hopefully next week.